Right, so we're here for the World War One Commemorative Concert. It's a very exciting occasion. We've been preparing this for a while. I'm with the Whiteshill and Muscombe Community Choir. We're all ready to sing our hearts out. So, and we've got the choir here from the school as well, so they're going to be joining us. So hope it goes well.
Event, and there's an awful lot of hard work gone into it, and everybody deserves a lot of credit for it. Very, very good community stuff.
So it's going to be a good, it's going to be a good afternoon. Very moving, I think.
The ladies are going to be wearing the gentlemen today. These are made from recycled plastic bottles, and I've been making them and selling them for the British Legion. And so far, I've raised £450. Plastic bottles, yes, and glass painted. And then sequins and beads put in the middle, and then obviously a pin behind. And we have rings as well. So, yes.
No, we're really looking forward to it. I'm sure it'll go very well. We've worked very hard, and today it's going to show.
People have found stories from the area, people have found photographs that we're going to show and so on. So we've tried to create a feeling for what was going on here 100 years ago and commemorate those who lost their lives at that event.
Over by Christmas, well, let's hope that we'll be, in the next 100 years, looking back on this and saying, well, maybe we learned a few lessons. Bless you.
Research for their school syllabus, and they've been working in conjunction with Melanie Cormack-Hicks, who's been assisting them with the artwork. Three panels in the church here.
South East London. Here are some of his recollections. I have never been so frightened. If you ran away, you would be tied to a gun and shot for cowardice. This was the beginning of all the bad times to come. Lots of men lost their toes to frostbite. All of us were covered in vermin. At one time, our trench was full of mud and water after torrential rain. When daylight came, we soon found out where the Jerrys were. Both of us were on top of our trench, getting the water out and trying to dry out. Not a shot was fired.
Wives group.
Yeah. Group, yeah.
I've been meeting every month for 45 years.
Wow.
And started so, when we were all young mums. Well, they're not all.
Oh, 270, I believe.
270
teas? Yeah, 30 squashes for the children. Well earned, I should think.
Whiteshill community choir, and I play the piano for them, so it's amazing, and there's so many people here, and it's really great to perform, and I hope everyone's enjoying it.
We're really enjoying it, and it's making us think about what happened 100 years ago.
Yes, the song choice is really good.
So the children have been rehearsing about five or six times in school for about an hour and a half each time, and they've been really committed. They've done a fantastic job, really worked hard, learnt everything from memory, really given it their all. I think you can really hear that they know what they're doing and that they've really got into the spirit of the occasion.
It's very good. I'm very happy that it was my primary school to doing this. Just want to say, really enjoying it. I'm glad that they're like supporting the World War One. And yeah.
March, she called out. 'Tis the lads off to war. The quiet male voices were singing as they marched past St Paul's Church, their boots kicking up dust in the warm September air. Remember our song, when the fields are white with daisies on return? Nan nodded. I'll sing it every day. A slow trickle of men did return, blinded, legless, armless, breathing raucously where the gas was eating away their lungs. They told no tales of excitement, just the stupidity of being ordered to go over the top in full range of machine guns, of charges that took them straight into a barrage of heavy artillery and thick cloying mud in trenches teeming with rats. Still, there was no word of June, and the sheep were grazing above Primrose Hill. Nan was walking back home after another day at the school when she saw a figure sitting on the stone wall outside the Star Inn. Could it be? Her heart skipped a beat and she waved.
This is your moment. Please join in with this very well-known chorus and have a good sing-along.
Whether she loves me or loves me not, sometimes it's hard to tell. Yet I am longing to share my lot with beautiful Daisy Bell.
Thank you.
Okay, well, I've been with the choir since the spring of last year, and when we started, we were just a group singing just for enjoyment, just Wednesday by Wednesday in the village hall, with no real aspirations of concert performances. But with the arrival of Luke Bailey, we've moved on to greater things, and this is our third performance in 2 weeks. And we're really enjoying public appearances now and looking forward to doing greater things next year.
Sincere, and let not the memory be forgotten.
Right, I'm Gary. I'm playing the cornet for Las Post and Rivali today.
Wow. And you're doing it up in the loft?
Oh, we're doing it up in the gallery, not the loft, the gallery.
I think it went very well, actually. I think it's our best performance. We've given them the 3 or 4 now, and I think this was the best of the lot. And I think we're very pleased. And most importantly, we enjoyed it. We had a great time.